Today I will be creating some envelopes with Craftreat chalk paints. I'll be using Craftreat chalk paint toasted oatmeal, peacock paradise, grapevine, and I'll be showing you how to use the metallic gold and metallic silver, and I will also be using the Craftreat stencil. It's Lily and Iris CTS 150 basket weave CTS 2024, and I will be using chiplets, Nestabilities chiplets. So let's begin. To begin with, I have cut the cardstock by 7 inches by 4 inches. So now I will start taking some chalk paint. Peacock Paradise, a little bit is enough, and I will use a little bit of oatmeal. Now I'll mix both them. Now the next step is I will just use a little bit of water and make sure that it is spreaded very well. Now I'll take the cardstock and I'll start dabbing it. And I'll heat it. Now you need to keep doing this until and unless you get your desirable texture. You can even use a tissue to get this dry. Now what is the use of using the chalk paints? The chalk paints don't give you a fade look. So I feel it's a very good idea to use chalk paints as your base. Now I think I am done, and I might even just spread a little bit and just nip it so I get a full image covered up. And I'll just leave it to dry. Now since I have this left, I will be creating one more background using the grapevine. Again, I'll take a little bit and I'll just put some water and mix the water. Now I feel this is a very great way to get texture, and you can make such quick and easy envelopes. See, look at the color. Wow, this is just amazing. And I'll use some of this color. Look at the combination. Wow. I am in love with these chalk paints. These are just amazing. Look how beautiful texture you are getting. Now again, I will heat this. And if you are not satisfied with the texture, you can keep on building layers. Again, I might go with one more layer, whatever is left. I'll put some water and I'll start dabbing it. Can you see the amazing result you are getting with these two colors? Isn't it so pretty? And look at the beautiful texture. Now I am going to zazz up my project by using a little bit of metallic silver. And again, I will just put some water, mix it up, mix it well so that there are no lumps. Now I will just use it and dab it, and I'll leave it to dry, or you can even use your heat gun to dry. So now can you see how beautiful textures we have got for the base of our envelopes? Now let's move on to the next step. Now I will take some grapevine and mix a little bit of oatmeal with it. I'm using a different brush. Make sure not to use the same brush so that you don't contaminate your chalk paints. Now I will mix them both so that I get a little bit of lighter effect. So now next I will use a modeling paste. I will mix some modeling paste with this. And see the beautiful color. This is such a beautiful color. And have you noticed something? This color goes very well with your Distress Ink Victorian Velvet. Now I have got the desired result. So now let's move on to the next one. Now I am using this stencil and I'll take my envelope. I will take the base of my envelope and make sure that I secure the stencil and the envelope very well with the help of a painter's tape, so that it don't move in between. For me, I feel 2 are enough, but if you are not comfortable, go ahead with putting more. So now let's begin. Now I will be using the modeling paste which has been mixed with the chalk paints. These chalk paints are very versatile. You can use them in so many different ways. Look how beautifully it smoothly moves on. And these chalk paints are so smooth. I just fell in love with the texture of the chalk paints. And I must say, Craftreat stencils are just amazing and a boon for all crafters. You can do so many things, not only mixed media, you can make so many projects out of these stencils. Now I will just lift it up and shift so I cover the rest of the envelope base. Be careful while lifting this. And you can just wipe it off with the tissue so that you don't spoil it. Now I'll make sure that I place it properly. Again, I will just cover up the left part. Now the most interesting part, how can you give a little bit of different look to your background? You can use some glitter and just pour over it. Since the modeling paste is wet, so it will take on all the glitter and it will stick. Can you look? Wow. This is just ready for any, you know, you can just give it like this also. And it just looks so awesome. But wait, we have more. So keep on watching. Now I was left with a little bit more paste. And I wanted a little lighter look. So what I decided, I decided to take some more modeling paste and mix them. So you will get a lighter shade. You can even give an ombre effect to your projects. Now, I have again secured my stencil and I'll start using it. It is not necessary that you give a whole stenciling to your envelope. You can even go with a little bit. It's completely up to you how you want to give. But I must say, you can complete so many envelopes in a little bit of time. And I think we Indians have so many festivals which require us to give the money envelopes, and envelopes are always in demand. Again, I'll clear it a little bit and then I'll complete the rest of the pack. So I decided to make another one with using this stencil and the craft treat Peacock Paradise, and I mixed some modeling paste and I got this result. Now I am left with some of the modeling paste. So what I'll do, I'll take a blank paper and I'll just create texture, and I might use it in future because I was left with something. So I decided to just go ahead with this kind of a little bit of texture. Look how beautiful effect you are getting, and you don't waste anything. And you are ready with another base in just 2 minutes. Don't forget to clean your stencils immediately because we have used modeling paste. You can just put them under running water and use a little soap with a little bit of scrubber, and see, nothing has happened to the stencil. So now let's move on to the next part. Okay, I always like to add some kind of element to my envelopes because it gives a different look only. So I will be showing you how you can make some elements using the floral envelopes. Over here I have taken some vellum, and again I will secure it with the tape. Now I am using the white ink pad and I'll just dab it. Now once I see that the whole area is covered with the white embossing, I'll just remove, lift it up, and I'll use some embossing powder. I have mixed clear embossing powder and glitter, and I'll make sure that I cover the whole area. Now I'll just heat it up. I'll keep this aside. Then I'll just heat. And while heating, just make sure that you are moving your heat gun in a circular motion so that each and every area gets heat up. Can you see the beautiful image? I am just loving this. Look how instantly we got an element. No need to color, no need to do anything. So now I'll do with the next one. I'll repeat the same procedure with the iris one. Now once I see that the whole area is covered with the white embossing, I'll just remove, lift it up, and I'll use some embossing powder. I have mixed clear embossing powder and glitter, and I'll make sure that I cover the whole area. Now I'll just heat it up. I'll keep this aside, and I'll just heat. And while heating, just make sure that you are moving your heat gun in a circular motion so that each and every area gets heat up. Can you see the beautiful image? I am just loving this. Look how instantly we've got an element. No need to color, no need to do anything. So now I'll do with the next one. I'll repeat the same procedure with the iris one. Now I just went around and did some fussy cutting. I am done with my fussy cutting. Now I am giving you another option. If you don't want to use embossing powder, then the other way to use the stencil. Now what I'll do, I'll take a white paper and I'll just secure it with the tape. Now I will use some distress ink. I have used Victorian velvet. Just go from center to outward. This way you will get a look like blending look from dark to light, and it looks so awesome. Now if you further want to enhance, then you can just use glossy accent, put some glitter. It completely depends upon the budget of your client or what you want to make. So I am using the Victorian velvet on the leaf, on the flower portion. Now I will show you how you can make the leaf. So for the leaf, I'll be using peeled paint. And I'll just go around it. Over here I am giving two shades, a little bit of peeled paint and a little bit of Victorian velvet. Now slowly lift it and just see, wow, can you see the beautiful look you got it? Same way you can do with the iris. So now what I'll do, I'll just stick this to the base of the to the envelope. And I have cut it according to the size of the chiplets, and I'll stick it this way and see how you can use it. You can use it this way, you can use it this way. You can even use a little bit of a butterfly. You can use the best compliments. So there are so many ways you can make them. Now another one what I did is I just stick this, and then I use the circle nestabilities, and I will put the embossed one and I'll use it this way, and I'll put the best wishes. So can you see how beautiful we can create envelopes with using chalk paints and stenciling in quick way? I hope you enjoy the tutorial. If you try, do let me know. Do tag us, Craftreat.